What's up, humans of planet Earth? In this video, I'm going to talk about why we need bees. For several years, bees around the world have been in crisis. Beekeepers were finding their bees were dying in alarming numbers. It was discovered that a parasite had invaded the hives, killing the bees, and the problem was spreading around the world. Globally, there are more honeybees than other species of bee and insects that pollinate, so they are the world's most important pollinator of food crops. About a third of the world's food supply depends on pollinating insects, like honeybees. They are responsible for the production of 70% of fruits, vegetables, seeds, and nuts. Honeybees can also pollinate alfalfa, which are fed to cattle, which help produce meat and dairy products. Honeybees also produce cotton plants, which helps us, humans, produce a very common material for our clothes. Bees even help us produce beeswax, which is contained in some beauty products. Bees are very important to us. If they die, thousands of plants will also die. If the plants die, people will starve and may also die. Since 2006, bees have started to disappear. Millions of beehives have died out in the last few years. 5 million hives from 1988 to 2.5 million in 2015. Isn't that scary? Man-made problems. Bees can get stressed from human activities, such as lawn mowing and construction. It also causes them a loss of habitat. Pesticides, such as neonicotinoids, affect the nervous systems of bees. The bees can accidentally carry it into their colonies, which kills the whole colony. It can also make the bees fly away from their hives, get lost, and die, separated from the others. Natural problems. A microscopic creature called a carabus woody hurt the breathing tube of bees by feeding from the fluids in them, weakening them, spending their whole lives inside them. This is a picture of a varroa destructor. Varroa destructors lay their eggs on the larva before the bees cover it with a wax capping. The eggs hatch and the young mites and their mother feed on the developing bee. When the bee chews its way through the wax capping and releases itself from its cell, it releases the mother mite and her babies. The babies then start the process over and over again for 10 days. After a few months, the whole beehive dies. When outside of the cell, the mites also suck the fluids of bees and weakens them. They also transmit viruses that harm the bees even more and can make them unable to use their wings. What can we do to help? Use organic pesticides. Grow flowers that bees love, such as mint, sunflowers, poppies, black-eyed Susan, and honeysuckle. Buy or build your own beehive as a home for them. This will help the bees by giving them a home because many bees are suffering from a loss of habitat. This picture is of the beehives that my grandparents made for their backyard. They drizzled several colors of paint on them to make them more attractive to the bees. Isn't it super cool? So proud of them. Even the smallest creatures play a very important role in all of our lives. Look after them. Thanks for listening!